So we will continue our discussion on this thing. Before that, what we'll do is basically we'll start copying the complete Hadoop package into our system. Currently, we have this machine created in which we need to install Hadoop, but we do not have anything as of now copied into this machine that will help us to install Hadoop. Okay, so one more way I will tell you how to connect with it is called WinSCP. WinSCP is the utility or tool that will help you to connect over the SSH protocol from your base machine to your virtual machine. Okay, so not only this two, you can connect two different types of machines using this WinSCP. Okay, so I will put 192, this is the IP address of my VirtualBox machine master 2. So it's 131, its username is root and password is Nimanth. So I am going to, again, it is also asking me the, caching the public key of it. So I will say update. Okay, so to understand this, basically, this particular part over here, on the right side over here, this is Windows, this is Linux part, I will say Linux. This is Linux operating system on this side. And on this side, there is a Windows operating system. Okay, you can just drag and drop the things. This is Windows 7 or whatever I'm using. You can just drag the drop between the two operating systems and it will just copy the data from here to there. That is very easy to use WinSCP and have the data being copied from Windows to Linux or Linux to Windows, vice versa, both the ways it is possible. Okay, we need to put one installable of Hadoop that is almost around 4 GB of size, needs to be copied somewhere in my Linux. Okay, so the folder or directory is this one, /www.where/www/html. I will tell you more on that. This is our home directory of our web HTTP server. Okay, and the file that I'm going to copy is complete package of Hadoop or HTTP 2.5. okay, so that already had shared with you. You just need to download and unpackage it with somewhere. Okay, and then you just need to copy that. So HTTP 2.5, there is a repo folder under it which you need to bring from here to here. Okay, since it is a large file, it will take some time. Okay, and it starts getting copied from Windows side to the Linux side. Okay, so let it copy and continue our discussion. So when you talk about OpenSSH, it is a secured shell, the way of communicating between client and server in a secured way. And the secure thing we will get by doing the encryption of both the messages sending from either ends. So OpenSSL is the technique. There are a few more techniques like RSA, DSA. These are all encryption techniques, encryption algorithms rather. Okay, that you will use in order to encrypt your message so that nobody can easily decrypt it. That's how we can, make your messages more safer. Okay, so how does this communication happens is basically what happens is, there is a server and then you have client. So suppose if your server is having SSH installed, okay, just in case all the Linux machine by default have the SSH service installed and running and getting up at the boot. Okay, whenever you restart any of your Linux machine, your SSH will always be there. Okay, it means that there is a public private key pair already have over here. So I will say pub means public and PRI means private key. There are two types of keys. Okay, public keys will be distributed to all the clients. Okay, so as soon as this client hits this machine, okay, the public key will be gone to client. Okay, and that's what where the message will appear that, okay, do you want to cache this public key in the cache of PuTTY? So in our case, the PuTTY is our client. Okay, so PuTTY say yes, and this public key will be cached over here, so it will get the public key. Okay. So what has been done is basically as soon as you hit that IP address, it hits the public key. Oh, sorry, it actually encaches the public key. Okay. And when it's encaged the public key, then it will get the connection and it will ask you for your root username and password. Okay, that's what we have done. So when we say username, so root and the password, we have sent two different things. But then they did not went to the server in what form? In clear text form. Okay. The user ID and password, they got encrypted with this particular key called public key. Okay. So this public key is OpenSSL or RSA or DSA key basically. Okay. With the help of that, all the messages will be encrypted. Okay. So let's say I have sent root as a user ID and password as Mimant. So these are some clear text that we have seen on the screen. But again, when it hits to the server, it was not in the clear text at all. Both root and Mimant will be encrypted. Okay. Or had been encrypted using the public key that the PuTTY has cached from the server. Okay. And when that message, the packet of user ID and password has reached on the destination side, this server has decrypted it and said, okay, the root is the user. Okay. Root user is okay. And what is the password? Password Mimant is also there. So both are matching. It means that now the PuTTY can be granted access to the server because he has provided the correct username and password. Okay. So then response will be sent back to the from the server to PuTTY, and again server, what server will do, it will encrypt the message with its private key. Okay, so it will use its private key, encrypt the message, that message will be gone here and it will be decrypted by the public key or the client. So public key will be used on the client side for decrypting and encrypting the messages, and private key mostly used on the server side to decrypt and encrypt the things. Okay, so this is how the communication will happen and get secured, so that nobody within the network, if somebody intercept the messages, they cannot get anything, just garbage, because even if they try to, you know, decrypt it, it will take 100 of years. Okay. Even if you try to run some automated way of, you know, decrypting the messages. Okay. It is very difficult. So most of the online transaction will be actually secured by OpenSSL RSA DSA with 1024 bit or 2048 bit of encryption algorithms. Okay. And that's why, I mean, most of us will actually trust on the websites that will provide us the information before it starts the online transaction, that this transaction is going to be encrypted by OpenSSL or RSA DSA with 10248 bit. Okay, so this is what has happened when you connect to PuTTY, and same thing has happened when we try to connect it with WinSCP. Okay, again, WinSCP is SSH client, though PuTTY is mostly command based. WinSCP is like kind of GUI based, in which it will just provide you the facility of copying the data from here to there. Okay, because there is no direct way other than, because though we are on the same hard disk, right? On the same hard disk, you have Windows as well as on this Linux also, 50 GB of your hard disk is actually associated with this Linux operating system. But still, they both being the same part of your hard disk, you cannot directly copy the things. Okay, you still require some kind of third party softwares that will copy the data from Windows to Linux and Linux to Windows. Okay, so let it copy and then we will talk further on this. Okay.